Hi, today we'll be talking about Facebook page shops. In my previous video, I talked about Facebook shops. It's a bit different from Facebook page shops. Okay, and in that previous video, you can check the link on the description box below. I talked about this Facebook shops, which is gonna be launched by Facebook soon. It's launched on May, but it's still not widely used yet. And I think only certain countries or certain Facebook page can use Facebook shops. And in the video, I keep talking about old Facebook shops, new Facebook shops. Apparently, this is could be due to they want to differentiate it. So they call the old version, which is Facebook page shops, and the new one that they are launching is Facebook shops. So I'm going to show you a bit of example using Spanx as well about how a Facebook page shops look like, right? See, it's even written here. Starting 19 May, a small number of businesses that use page shops. So they specifically want you to know that this is called page shops. It will be transitioned to Facebook shops. Just differentiate them. So, okay. I guess that the feature will be a bit different, right? And then you can add to page shops. Then the feature best serve merchants. Okay. This is very important, right? They recommend the Facebook page shops in selling clothing, accessories, home furniture, and baby or children products. Yeah, this is something to take note on. For this one, you cannot sell a digital products, only physical items, and you have to agree to merchant terms. Right? You can add as many products as you want. You can customize your product inventory the same as all the other shops. The content is communicate with customers. That is why you want to do everything in the same app itself, so that you can communicate with customers. If you do it in website, you need to install plugin whether to your Messenger or to your WhatsApp or to whichever chat that you have, which makes it a bit difficult. But when you do it in Facebook itself, you can just communicate with customers. Customers can communicate with you directly. So that's one thing that's good with Facebook page shops. Okay, so this is something to take note. When you're creating a Facebook page shop, you need to change the template to a shopping template. I'll show you all later how to change it, right? And you need to agree to a merchant term. Again, I keep repeating about that. So do look into the merchant terms. I'm not gonna go through in this video. You just have to. I'm gonna link these two links in the description box below. So now let's go to a example of Facebook shops. Okay, so this is a clothing brand Spanx, right? And you see the page, you don't see much, but in the phone, you can see very clearly there's an option for you to shop. So you just click on the word shop here, and you can see all the products here. And then when you click on it, it pop up. Then it will show the details, etc. And then once you click check out on website, it will go to the website for you to check out. And just click on it, and then you will see that you open this Thai shop thing is direct to the product page. Then where you can add to bag. Interesting, not add to cart. Anyway, so yeah. So now, so this is the basic of Facebook page shops. Facebook page shops. Okay. Although in the page it just say Facebook, it just say shops. But they want to separate into Facebook page shops. So now I'm going to create something like this. Not something like this, I mean just show you how to create it. Okay, so let me just show you the page. Okay, so this is the page that I recently created, right? As you can see here, there's nothing much here, right? So you go to more, you can see that there's no shops here. There's no shops option here. That's because when I created this page, I put it under business category. So in business category, you cannot see shops. Right, to go for shops, you have to go to page settings, and then you go to templates and tabs, and then the current template is business, right? So you just have to edit and put in shopping, design to showcase shopping, so you can rearrange things like that. Okay, let's just apply template first. So you can see now that's different. It's a bit different now. There's event posts and shops. So usually, I think like for Spanx case, the shop is just beside home. So because they know what they're doing, they're selling things, right? So just have to put shops there and review there right in front. So you can rearrange it, you can put groups, you can toggle certain things and on certain things and off certain things. So you can, for example, you don't want events, you can just toggle it off, right? So with that, you have shopping for it already. So now let's go back to the page. Let's set up. Let's do a simple setup. I don't have a physical product, just to show you how is it easily can be done, right? Okay, now let's go to more. Okay, it's still 01. Let me just refresh. Okay, as you can see, there's shop here, right? So you just click on shops. So they will always ask you to add a shop accessory page. Please agree to certain condition to cover. listing of product, etc, etc. So you can just read it if you need, which is they keep mentioning the merchant, what's that called? You have to agree on the merchant terms, right? So let's just agree to it for now, because I'm not going to put any product, just to show you all. Okay, so now there's two different ways of checkout. So for Spanx itself, there's checkout on another website, right? There's some way so you can message to buy. This is when people usually PM. PM is personal message. Or what they do is when they're interested in product, they'll click on the message button and they'll message you directly. So I don't have a website for this, so just click message to buy. If you're on our website, you can just link this page, this product page directly into this link, right? So I'm in Malaysia, okay, let's just set up in Malaysia Ringgit. So now everything is here. So you can see some tips of how to get more out of your shop here. Just make sure you read as much as you can. So describe what I sell. So this one currently I'm not selling anything. So there's a lot of things you can put, manage your shop, improve your shop, etc. Add product. So you can just add picture or video, your video is good. So there's a recommended photo guideline as well. So about page shops, it's the same page, it's here. So now about listing. Okay, so you need at least one image, you need a title, you need a product description. So there's a specification from it as well. Please go through it because I know a lot of us just want to faster get the things done, but for Facebook itself, it's a bit sensitive. It's a platform that will usually ban people. So just make sure you read things and make sure you are compliant with whatever rules that they set, right? So you can just put price tag, the name, you can put on sale or not. If you put on sale, then what happened? There'll be sale price. Then you can put a description, you can share this product on your page, in stock, no in stock, right? Visibility, product condition, new, unfurbished, views, fair. So this is actually very basic, right? It's just for people to contact you. There's necessarily nothing much for you to add here, right? For example, you can sell just men clothes, right? So it's just as simple as that. It's really not for complicated items. For example, like you want to sell like a calculator, right? It's not as simple as that. You can, of course, you can put all of this in the description box below. It's always good to have this as well. Because you want people to message, right? Message you and just put the condition, whether it's a used item or new or refurbished and things like that. Just cancel. So when you have your products, it will all be here. So I guess when you have to go shops here, it's all here. So the moment you have it, you'll be here. Shops, collections. Yes, collections is actually, for example, let's see if they have any collections here or not. No, they didn't do collections. So collections are like group, your product groups. So you can see your order, pending order. So I assume that when people message you, you'll be here, right? Nothing here, because I didn't add anything, right? I guess that is the part that they're gonna really fully link together with the Facebook shops, not Facebook page shops. But for you to really get started, you want to have a shop that people know, right? For example, you have an e-commerce store, you want to link towards the Facebook page. That's all you can do, right? You can just put all the photos here. As you can see, it's very simple. So there are the photos here, the price, the discount if they have, you can save. Basically, put all the details here. Access only. So I guess that because they show it's SS, but inside here they can choose the size. So it's up to you to choose size. I think they can put comma, etc. Right? And for example, if you use the link, when you check out on website, then you go to the link. Right? So it's actually that simple. So when you want to if you cannot find the shop option, just change your team into the shops, and then on the shopping, in the shopping, change it into shopping template, and then you'll be able to add your product already. So I hope you like what I shared. So this is just a simple tutorial, and do read through whatever terms and conditions that are set by Facebook, because you don't want to get banned. And if you like what I share, do subscribe to my channel. Yeah, like and comment. If you have any comments, feel free to hit me up in all my social media. So I see you in my next video. Bye bye.